Filing your taxes for the very first time can be really intimidating. You don't want to pay more than you owe, but you also don't want an IRS agent knocking at your door. I promise it's not that hard. In this video, I'm going to walk through step by step exactly what you need to do to file your taxes for the very first time. I'm going to walk you through using TurboTax. It's a really easy software and it's a good one for beginners. And if you have simple taxes, it really should be 100% free. Now, if it does prompt you to say that you must pay something, I'd switch to a different software because there are much cheaper options out there. But if you only have simple things like a W-2, the TurboTax Free Edition should work for you, and do not accept any of the upgrades. You don't need them. The first thing you need to do is gather up all the tax forms you may have gotten. You might be getting a W-2 from a regular employer or a 1099 of some variety. There's lots of different kinds of 1099s. There's some for self-employment income, for government payments, for interest from bank accounts, from dividends, from stocks. But those are all different types of income that all come on 1099s. You also might get some forms for some deductions that you might qualify for. Some of the most common of those forms are the ones for student loan interest paid or for school tuition payments. So we're gonna start off at the TurboTax website, which is turbotax.intuit.com. First, we need to click to create an account. So just fill this out and create an account. Now TurboTax is gonna start asking you questions to help you figure out what kind of tax situation you have. My sample person that we're using, his name is John Smith, and he's a single 18-year-old guy who pays rent for an apartment. So we're gonna click that he has a job with a W-2 and he paid rent. None of these other things apply to him. And we're gonna click that he can do it on his own. You'll notice this also says that it costs $0 for the state return, which is really good, that it's free for both of them. We're gonna choose the basic option that really is free. And we're gonna start walking through their questions about our tax situation. Filling out John's basic information. John didn't file taxes last year. John is single, but if you're married, that does definitely affect your taxes. And he didn't have any of these other situations going on. John did also have a bank account with interest and got a 1099 INT, so I'm going to check that box. You'll see you have other options that you can check here if you had other things that apply to you. Okay, it's just summarizing things here. Now it's asking us to sign their legal agreements. You can read all the fine print here if you want. John's agreeing to all of it. So now we're going on to the personal info section. You do have to fill out your social security number here, and I made one up for John. And you do have to fill out some kind of job title for yourself. Don't stress about this too much. You can just write something pretty general. This is asking which states I lived in. John's a resident of Ohio and he did not live in another state. This is asking whether someone can claim me as a dependent on their tax return. If you are under 18, it's most likely you are a dependent. If you're between 18 and 24 and a full-time student, you're also pretty likely to be a dependent. If you're unsure of your status, ask your parents if they can claim you on their taxes. If they can claim you, even if they're not, you still have to check yes on that box. But John is living on his own and he's not a student, so he's not a dependent. John is not legally blind and John is still alive. And this is whether you want to change to a different language for what the IRS sends you. I'm gonna say no, because John speaks English. This is asking if John was a full-time student. No, he was not. But if you were a student, definitely follow those prompts and go through that, because you can get some good tax breaks if you're a student. John is single. This is asking if he supported himself during the year. And yes, John did support himself and pay for his own apartment and everything, so he's gonna say yes. This is where you could potentially be considered a dependent. No, John does not have any children. Just filling out his address. It strongly encourages you to use a phone number. I'm not using one just because I don't want this associated with my phone number, but you should use one if you can. John did not make any money in any other states, but if you did, you want to follow these prompts. And this is giving me the official filing status that I'm going to use with the IRS. John is single, so it's pretty simple, but if you are married, it could get a little bit complicated about what you choose. Just follow the prompts and use what it suggests. And then we just get a summary of his personal info. Okay, now we get to the part where TurboTax is trying to sell us more stuff. They're trying to sell us the plus support for $29. It's not necessary. So we're just gonna click not now. Again, we're staying on the free track here. Next up is the part where you add income. Okay, so we're gonna click work on my W-2 to get that entered. So the first thing it's asking for is employer ID. Notice that it says look in box B. So we're gonna pull up the W-2 and look for box B. So there's the employer identification number right there. Then click continue. So then it's giving you options of how to enter your W-2. You can upload it from your computer as a PDF if you have it on your computer. You could use your phone to take a picture of it, or you could click down here to just type the numbers in yourself. And I'm gonna click type it in myself. It brought box B over for you, and now you're gonna fill in the rest of it. I find it a lot easier if I can have a printed copy so I can look at this and type it in at the same time. But if you need to go back and forth on your computer or your phone, that's fine too. So here you can see box C with the employer's name and address. And then you see this is asking for box D and it says optional, and I look over and box D is empty on mine, so I click continue. And anytime you have an empty box on your form, you leave it blank in the system. Now you see this is asking for box 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If we look at the form, you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And you're gonna put all those in the boxes on TurboTax. And then you're gonna scroll down and it says less common items. So these are boxes 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11, 12. So we're gonna look and see these are 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. You see, we do have something in 12. All these are zero, so we can leave them blank. So let's fill out box 12. So for box 12, we have to select a code, and then it says we can add another box 12 item. So let's go back and look at box 13. We do have the check mark for a retirement plan. Let's look at box 14. There's nothing there. Now box 15 is where your state information comes from. This first one, you're gonna choose the state, and then you're gonna fill out the rest of these boxes from your form. Those are gonna come from right here. Boxes 18 to 20 only apply if you have local income tax, and you're gonna see that on your W-2 right here. Here in Ohio, we have local income tax, but that's not terribly common. After those are all filled out, you might wanna double check them all and then hit continue. Then it's gonna ask if you have any unusual situations with your W-2. None of these things apply to us, and they're not gonna apply to most people. If you have more than one W-2, you can add another one right here. Nope, John did not have any stocks. He did not get a 1099-K. That could have come from a place like PayPal. You just follow the prompts if that's something that happened to you. And he doesn't have any foreign assets. Because I checked the box that he had a 1099-INT, it's adding this little section right here, so we're gonna start that. So this is asking about investment income in general, and it does include interest earned, and John had a savings account that earned interest, so we are gonna say yes to this. TurboTax is offering that it can connect to my bank to pull in my interest income, but I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna click enter a different way. And I'm gonna click 1099-INT, that's for bank interest, but you can see the other options that we could have in this section. So it's giving me options, I can bring it from my bank, I can upload it, or I can type it. I'm just gonna click type it myself. This is what John's fake 1099-INT looks like. He had a Capital One savings account and he earned interest of $57 last year. This form, it really only has one box filled in, so it's very easy to enter. This first number is the ID of the bank, and it should be on your form. And then you just put in the name of the bank here. It's only giving me box 1 and 3 because those are the only ones that are likely to need anything. And my form only has something in box number 1. So mine in box number 1 says $57.82. Pretty simple. And there's nothing unusual about this form. So that's all John has, so we're gonna keep going. So John's all done with income, but if he had any other kind of income, he can click here, and then he can find the type of income here. And you'll notice it lists the form numbers that he would use. But he's done, so we'll click here to continue. This is asking about a special situation that does not apply to John. You'll notice that most of these questions you're going to say no to. This is asking about virtual currency. John didn't do anything with that, so he's saying no. So now it's gonna find deductions that could save him something on taxes. This is giving you some more information about deductions. You can watch their information here, but we're just gonna keep going. None of these things apply to John. We're moving on to the next part. This is asking if John made estimated tax payments during the year. You would know if you had done this, and John did not. And he did not contribute to any kind of retirement account. And he didn't go to university. He also does not have an HSA. On to the next section. Continue. Now it's just gonna check if we have any uncommon tax situations. No, we do not have a nanny. We don't wanna give to the presidential fund. And we didn't get a PIN from the IRS. Okay, it is bringing up underpayment penalties. This is because I made John's taxes too low on his W-2. He didn't pay enough during the year. So it's saying he owes $20 in penalties because he underpaid this year. If something like that does happen to you, what you need to do for the next year is talk to your employer and adjust your W-4. Your W-4 is what tells your employer how much taxes to take out of your paycheck. I just messed up making this fake W-2. It actually said John does not have an underpayment penalty because you're not gonna have a penalty on your very first filing. Okay, so it's letting me skip all of these things if none of these things apply, and they don't. So we're gonna click let's keep going. And then it's gonna send me straight into the state taxes. Most of us do have a state income tax, although a few states don't. Usually your state return is really just a couple extra questions and it pulls everything over from your federal. It doesn't really take much in the software to do state after you've done federal. So because it's not actually tax time yet, it's saying it'll email me when it's ready to file. But if this were tax time at this point now, it would take me through a couple final steps to finalize the return. If you had some extra forms that weren't included in the free version in TurboTax, it would give you a message that you need to upgrade. TurboTax definitely gets too expensive if you need any more forms, and I would suggest switching over to FreeTaxUSA. FreeTaxUSA is 100% free for all federal returns with all forms. Their state returns do cost about $15, which is way cheaper than TurboTax, which tends to be over $100 for a lot of people. If you do decide to switch to FreeTaxUSA, I'd really appreciate it if you use my link that's down below in the top comment. After you finish filing through the system, it takes a little bit of time to process through the IRS system and your state system, and you'll get emails that say it has been accepted. It takes 1 to 2 days for it to be accepted. If you do owe money on your taxes, you can pay that with your bank account. Most of us are gonna get a refund though, and if you're gonna get a refund, you can fill out your bank account information and get it straight into your bank account. Usually takes a couple weeks for it to fully process and you get the money. There are also options to do it by check, but it's much better to do it with a bank account. If you have questions on getting started with your first tax return, feel free to leave questions down below. I can't promise I can answer all tax questions, but I can definitely help you get started. If you're not sure which software is the best for you, watch my video next about the best tax software for 2023.